It's been 1 year since the Deepwater Horizon oil rig exploded. The fishermen continue to suffer. Business owners continue to suffer. And many people say BP simply isn't doing what it said it would do.
And we are joined live now by one of the spokespeople for BP, Mr. Curtis Thomas. Thank you for being here.
You're very welcome. Thank you for having me.
You're in the lion's den, as it were. Governor Jindal earlier today sharply criticized BP for not doing what they said they'd do. Let's listen to that soundbite.
Okay.
Certainly, we continue to call on BP to fulfill the promises of their ads. We continue to call on BP to truly make it right. Here in Louisiana, we have over 300 miles of our coast that continue to be oiled.
So what about that? Is BP living up to its promises or not?
Well, we are, and it's a long-term commitment, and we've made that very clear. First off, I'd like to say today is really about those 11 men that died, and we owe it at BP, and the rest of the industry owes it to the memory of those men to do it right, and that's exactly why we will do it right. We want the lessons that we learned from this spill to go beyond what we know now and to actually help keep those memories alive. And we will do it right, and we're here for the long term.
There's a $20 billion fund out there. About $4 billion have been paid out so far. If you talk to people here on Grand Isle, if you talk to people in Venice, so many of them say, BP said they'd make us whole. We're not whole. We're not close to whole. They're not getting what BP said they would get.
Right.
What do you say to that?
So far, out of that $20 billion, $5 billion has been paid out. About $1.5 billion of that has been paid out right here in Louisiana. So Ken Feinberg is running the Gulf Coast Claims Facility, and he's in charge of most of those claims. BP, of course, handles the government claims. We know it's a long-term process. We know Mr. Feinberg is refining his process to meet the needs of the claims, and we believe that he'll follow the OPA laws and he'll satisfy those claims.
So why is the governor, Mr. Thomas, saying that things are not being done as BP said they would be done, if you say things are being done right?
Well, and I know that it's, once again, it's a long-term process, and that's exactly why we established the Gulf Coast Restoration Organization. To the claims issue, you know, we're looking, I know Mr. Feinberg is looking for proper documentation, and we've said we will pay legitimate claims, and we stand by that, and we will do it right.
It just seems like there's no rhyme or reason to a lot of the process, where some people who work together in the same building, one gets paid, one doesn't, they submit the same paperwork. It's so frustrating for a lot of the people out there who are still waiting for their money when it doesn't make a lot of sense to them.
Again, the Gulf Coast Claims Facility, they handle those claims, and we put that money out there on the table in a good faith effort because we knew that these claims would be coming in. We are here for the long term. BP's not going anywhere. The Gulf Coast Claims Restoration Organization is a permanent facility that's going to stay here until the job is done.
I keep harping on the environmental issue specifically because Parish President Billy Nungesser from Blackmans Parish says that the oil is on the bottom of the ocean and the storms and the waves kick it up on the marshes, and they're losing 5 feet of marsh every day. So what's BP doing about that?
Well, we know that the marsh, we have done about 95% of the coast that was oiled. 5% of that is left. We know that the marsh areas are areas that we are currently working on. We also know that the sand, that the tar balls will be kicked up on the beaches, and we also know that we'll be responding to those. So we haven't gone anywhere. The teams will be there to respond. As far as the marshes, we've done tests and studies. We don't want to do more harm than good, and that's our major goal there. That's a very delicate area, and we know that. So the scientists are helping us determine the exact ways to clean up those marsh lands, and that's the process we'll use. We'll let science help us guide our response.
All right, Curtis Thomas, BP, thanks for being here.
Thank you very much.
You got a tough road ahead.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We have much more.